Today, boys and girls, Praxis Factory Productions presents a brand new presentation of The Three Little Pigs, read to you by Jonathan David Hawkins. We hope that you will enjoy it. Once upon a time, there were three little pigs who decided that it was finally time for them to move away from home. And so, those three little pigs, each with a kiss on the cheek from their mother, set out the door. Now, the first little pig was as lazy as can be. The second little pig was not quite so lazy as the first. And the third little pig was not lazy at all. But together, they set off down the road. Now, the first little pig decided to build a home right away in the first clearing he found. But the only thing there to build a home out of was the straw from the field. Now his brother said, "Little pig, this is no place to build a safe home." And he just said, "Pshaw, I'll just build my home right here. I've got everything I need with this straw." And he built his house quick as could be and lazed away his days. Now the second little pig made a little bit further, but he too was very lazy. And so, halfway through the woods, he stopped in a clearing and said, "I'll build my house right here." And his brother said, "Dear little pig, this is no safe place to build a home. Look, there's nothing but flimsy sticks." And the second pig said, "Oh, it's okay. This'll be just fine." And so, he built his home from the flimsy little sticks and then slept the night away. But the third little pig kept walking all through the night until he got to a nice, great, big, open clearing with plenty of clay to build strong bricks from to build his home. And that's exactly what he did. Now, I have to be honest, even though his brothers, those other two little piggies, loved him dearly, they laughed at him while he built his home because it took him days and days of hard work. But he just kept right at it and stayed his course. And so the days went on until one day, the first little pig was enjoying a bright, sunny day when he heard a noise in the woods. And that noise did not sound friendly at all. So that little piggy went home as fast as his little hooves could carry him, and he closed himself up in his flimsy little straw house. And the wolf came up to him and said, little pig, let me in." And the little pig said, "Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin." And the wolf just laughed and said, "I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in." And sure enough, the wolf took in a deep, deep breath, and he let loose with a huge burst of air and knocked down that flimsy little house. That was the last that anyone ever saw of the first little pig. But not too much later, his brother, the second little pig, came to visit him. But where his brother's house had been was now just a clearing of battered pieces of straw, with little pink bits of what looked like used to be pig scattered here and there. And the second little pig got very scared indeed. And so he took off through the woods home as fast as his little piggy hooves could carry him. And he heard behind him the wolf coming at his heels. Now the little pig shut himself away inside his flimsy little house of sticks, and he shivered with fright. And the wolf approached the door and said, little pig, let me in. And the wolf said, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin. And the wolf just laughed. And he said, then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in. And sure enough, he took in a deep breath. And he let loose with a huge burst of air. And knocked that little piggy's house all into tiny little twigs. And the little pig had scampered out the back. And he ran away through those woods as fast as his pointy little piggy hooves could carry him, straight to his brother's door. And his brother was there waiting for him and said, dear little brother piggy, what is the matter with you? And he said, the big bad wolf is coming to get us. Quick, quick, or he'll make a lunch of the two of us. And his brother just chuckled and said, silly little brother, come on in. We'll be safe here at home. And sure enough, the door locked nice and tight. But as the day faded into night, they heard in the distance the sound of the wolf. Now the wolf approached the door and he said, little pigs, let me in. But the brother said, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin. And the wolf said, fine, then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in. And inside, the third little pig just laughed and said, do your best, Mr. Wolf. And the wolf took in a deep, deep, deep breath. And he let out the hugest burst of wind you ever did hear. But the little brick house stayed nice and tight and safe. And meanwhile, much to the second little pig's astonishment, the first little pig simply went about preparing dinner, and he filled a big kettle full of water, and he put the water on the stove, but did a curious thing. As the water came to a boil, he left the lid off. Now, as all this was going on in the house, the wolf, who was so frustrated with not blowing in the house, climbed up the side of that little brick house, and he crawled across the roof as sneaky as a thief in the night. And he scaled the sides of that little brick chimney, and he crawled over to the top and dropped in to eat the little piggies. But instead of landing at the bottom of a nice neat chimney, he fell right into a pot. And then the third little pig slapped the lid in the pot, clamped it down tight, and some hours later, wolf soup was served for dinner. And that concludes tonight's story. We hope that you enjoyed it and have pleasant, pleasant dreams until your next bedtime story.